It's a thin line between newborn and stillborn, full term and premature, between healthy and sick. If you're pregnant or think you are, getting prenatal care early is the most important step you can take. Don't put your baby's health on the line. Take care of yourself so you can take care of your baby. Find out now about getting prenatal care. Call 1-800-311-2229.
Hello, and welcome to Talk New York. Once again, another roundtable with Talk New York Girls. Hello, ladies. Welcome
Hi.
Here. We have Magdalene Friedman, Gifty Asiedu, and Anna Alford. Well, let's dig in. We're going through the news. There's a man out there who has sued his girlfriend for getting pregnant. He says he didn't want pregnancy, she didn't discuss it with him, and that she told him that she has taken birth control.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
What is this?
Let me say, this is ridiculous. He was engaging in an activity that was pleasurable for him, hopefully
right.
for her.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure this woman did not rape him. He has to take responsibility. How can he sue her for getting pregnant?
You know,
if he was mistrustful of the woman to the point that, you know, he felt she was lying about the birth control, maybe you ought to think about having sex with her in the first place, mm-hmm. or protect yourself, wear a condom.
Right. That is the issue.
No excuse.
That really,
no excuse.
Caught my attention is the fact that he's saying she says she's on the pill.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
first
why
of all,
is it right? Why is it her responsibility to
first
protect?
Of all, let's
right.
relationship. Relationship. The word means to relate
mm-hmm.
from one person to the other, mm-hmm. which means that if they were in a relationship, it's between two people.
Mm-hmm.
So it's as his responsibility as it was hers to protect her and also to protect himself.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And the pills, I mean, whatever contraceptives that you're on, it's not 100% guaranteed.
Okay.
I mean, that's basic knowledge.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So if she became pregnant, I mean, how dare he to say, I'm going to sue?
Yeah.
He enjoyed it the same way she enjoyed it.
That's what well, for me, I think I have a different view. The decision to have a baby or of having a baby in a relationship should be a rejoicing or a joyous moment.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
But once the decision is biased, it means there is no basis for the relationship. Women put themselves in these vulnerable situations and it appears as if their rights are being violated, and it's not so. If we learn how to maintain our values and assess who we want to be with, she would not have found herself in that situation. You understand?
Well, maybe she wanted it. Maybe yeah? she didn't care. Maybe she wanted to
well,
be pregnant.
So if the man is right, if she wanted to be pregnant, she knows. What if the man she doesn't even care for health reasons. This person is only dating her. They are not even married, and she has already decided to sleep with him without a condom. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
That's another thing that women, we have to take a look at. Sex is not something we just jump around and have all around.
Mm-hmm. So this was consensual. Mm-hmm. I mean, they both agree that they will engage in this activity.
Mm-hmm.
So if there's a problem where things did not go as they expected, I mean, mm-hmm. he should be as responsible.
Exactly.
I mean, in terms of what you said is very valid, but that's mm-hmm. a different topic altogether. I mean, we can go into it in terms of what's right and what's
mm-hmm.
wrong morally.
Okay.
But this is something that was consensual, and you know, there was an accident.
It wasn't consensual. Means there should be no dispute. But if the man is saying no, there's no agreement.
To have sex. Activity.
Well, he agreed to have the pleasure. He just
right. yes,
it,
yeah, for the baby. Yeah,
not for the baby.
Well, not for
it started
baby.
Out as having fun, and
mm-hmm.
something happened.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
The woman knows what she was doing.
They both knew what they were doing. Both of them
having sex means making a baby.
No. us.
Yeah, no, that is that. That's the whole thing of sex. But we use it for pleasure.
But the guy knows that too. he knows that sex equals the baby.
Right.
Well, to me, in my view, or in my little holistic whatever, sex is something that should be sex is something that should be celebrated based on the love and affection that is existing within the relationship. Right. You understand? Mm-hmm. The same way we plan to celebrate birthday parties and things like that is the same way we should celebrate love.
So every sex that you had, you had it to procreate every sexual interaction that you had.
Religiously, yes, by virtue of mankind, that is to procreate.
No.
Yeah, but we use it for
So how many times have you
sex? Is
sex?
A gift from God. Sex is a gift from God, given to us to enjoy.
Where are your children? From God.
Life
is a gift from God. Not
are you a virgin now?
No.
I was married before.
I've celebrated sex before.
I have
celebrated sex. Sex is celebrating love. It's celebrating love in a relationship. So if these people make
it. How many celebrations have you had?
I don't want. But what I'm saying is, the beauty of sex, we don't look at it anymore. We just jump into relationship. This is where everything goes wrong. You see somebody you like, you go after the person, and it has to be like so.
Sex is an animal instinct, and as human beings, we're animals. Even people who are mentally retarded engage in sexual activities. So imagine the normal person. Yes, in a religious sense, sex is supposed to be done for procreation.
Yeah.
But on the human level, in today's society, we do it for pleasure. So for you to sit here and tell me you have celebrated.
Because mankind, we are always
coined another word for having sex, celebration.
It's celebration. That's the only way it should be.
Magdalene,
having sex is celebration. Just celebrate love.
In this relationship,
there was no love. Okay, there was no love, and they shouldn't be having sex.
We haven't talked about love.
Love has nothing to do with it. We're talking about sex.
Well, I am telling. I just define sex that sex is a celebration of love and affection existing in a relationship. If it is not there, it's not there.
What's love got to do with it? Okay, what's love got to do with it?
Well, we're talking about the materialistic view of sex. We're not talking about the real thing. You see, you people.
I'm glad that
you people are the one that send this different message out there. All we want them to do is.
Well, you have been celebrating.
You have been celebrating. Look how nice you look. No, people who celebrate smile a lot. People who celebrate smile a lot.
You know why?
Because I don't smile.
You know why? We celebrate a lot because it takes the stress away.
That's why you're very depressed. Yes, you know, I got to do something.
I wish I did. My boyfriend and I are such old couples now. It's like we don't see each other anymore. But anyway, you've been celebrating. And if you go with the theory that you are trying to put out here, then it means that anytime you celebrate, you have the ultimate goal.
I like that.
And I'm asking you, since you celebrated some time ago, where are your children now?
Well, you see, like how you celebrate. When you celebrate, you plan for the celebration, a wedding, right? So you plan so that for security reasons, in case something goes wrong. So when I celebrate, I plan. So in case something goes wrong, that's where these people fail.
She's putting us all
I make security reasons while I celebrate. So that's why no babies came out of it. You only celebrated
three times. That's why you have three children.
No, I don't have three children. I don't. I wish I did.
She's trying to get a boyfriend now. She doesn't have any children.
She looks very sexy.
Oh, but this is the way you do it. So catch the flies. You know what I mean?
Men became flies. Okay, let's move on to the next one. Okay, there's a study done about American sex life, and it says that 43% of women and 31% of men are unsatisfied with their sex life. The men complain of premature ejaculation, and the women complain of the lack of orgasm. Where do you fall now?
I fall.
I am in the 43%.
Well, I'm absolutely in the 43% because I don't have anyone. So I'm definitely, and I think, let me add.
You're blushing when you talked about that.
Well, because I haven't had.
No, but
on a serious note, I think most of us, if not all of us, fall into that, have fallen into that 43% at one point in time. Am I not right?
Absolutely.
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's such a thing as, you know, finding somebody that you are sexually compatible with, that you were able to get orgasm.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I fall into the 43%, but in terms of sexual compatibility, I think sex begins in the mind. Mm-hmm. It depends on how you feel at the time that you engage in sex. Mm-hmm. You could be with a person for a whole year, and each time it's a different experience. Mm-hmm. If you're in the mood, it's a perfect. The guys are laughing.
Just get to it.
It's a mental frame.
It's a mental frame.
Okay, I mean, it depends on the person.
Exactly.
You know, whether it's spontaneous, whether it's planned, the candles, the flowers, they bought you a nice gift. It feels different each time. And also, if you're tired, of course, it impacts. So there's a lot of things that impacts on your sexual drive.
Right.
But you try to enjoy it.
When you were celebrating, are you in the 43% or were you, are you in the where did you belong?
Well, you know, usually I do it in the mind. But when we plan to do it,
to celebrate,
we start in the kitchen. You know, just one look.
It's all
tells you that it's ready. You know the time.
For somebody who is very conservative, you start from the kitchen.
Yeah, well, I'm telling you, by just looking in their eyes, looking each other in the eyes. Like, you know, the kids are all in bed.
You mean it's a whole seduction
process? The whole thing, yeah.
The language.
They look at you,
body
you know,
language,
when this person comes from the bathroom, what's going to
so
happen.
So do you turn the lights off or you leave the lights on?
No, we need to look into each other's eyes and search for the truth.
The truth?
Yeah.
What is the truth?
That's the truth for love. I search for lust.
No, say, if you look into any man's eye, you watch into their eyeball.
During sex?
Even before sex, during the celebration planning, you'll see that it's written 666.
The man
and the demon comes out, and the red. Aren't you
looking there? The red hat, right? Ready?
I checked before.
Okay. 31% of men have premature ejaculation. And I think we spoke before the show that that's so annoying. It's like,
yes.
One touch of the breast and the breast
is gone.
And the train is here. And it's like, hold on.
And then you have to wait another hour or so. You know,
you haven't been able to enjoy sex.
The celebration?
The celebration.
You haven't been able to.
Sometimes you dance a lot and get tired before the party is over.
Oh.
Yes.
I mean, I get you.
Well, we want you to get into that one. That's right.
We have a new word in our celebrate.
No, when you celebrate, it's really nice.
Uh-huh.
The beauty of the relationship. Oh, it's really nice when you celebrate love in any relationship. Let all the women out there have a different view of sleeping, going to bed with a man, and all the little animosity, the little things that causes friction in a relationship will just vanish.
Because of sex, celebration.
I disagree with you, Magda. Okay. I think sex begins from the time you wake up with a person.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and it's like sex becomes an end point. If you wake up, you're in a good mood, he caters to you, she caters to him, you have a good day together. I mean, once you get into the bedroom, you don't have to look into each other's eyes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It becomes part of you.
No, which means you have deviated from the celebration of sex, we said, is celebration of love and affection.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so
sex is
nothing. So it's the love you're talking about now.
Wow.
It's already
it's
there.
All together.
Yes.
Together.
So sex, we remove sex, it's just the action. It's love and affection. Yeah, no, it's just the action. It's you're talking about. I like what you're saying. Mm-hmm. The looking into each other's eyes, or when you said it, when
making
you wake up.
Making love is the end product mm-hmm. of your affection for the person.
You make love.
Yes, I make love, and I love making love.
Sex. You have
no,
sex.
I make
you
love.
Love.
I make love.
Make love.
That's
everything.
That's a difference.
The
having sex is exactly. There's a difference in having sex, and there's a difference
making
in making love.
Love.
I make love. I don't have sex.
No, this making love thing, we just, it's a word.
I am a virgin and I'm listening.
It's a made up thing. When they said I make, people thought when they said some people have sex, other people make love. It's when they want to get into inner thing, when the French people call it amour, it means the deeper love, part of the love. Mm-hmm. That's it. But sex itself is just a thing. But what makes up sex is love and affection. So when I wake up in the morning, if I'm not tired or whatever, my partner relates with my energy. That's why relationship, it's the same, like what that woman was talking about, the spirit or mm-hmm. whatever thing. It's mm-hmm. in between. When two people are together, they let the two spirits come together. They intertwine.
You guys are complicating
this. That's what I'm saying.
I just celebrate that thing.
Press the right buttons and we celebrate. That's it.
That's
don't call it anything else.
Right.
Celebration.
No, just celebrate.
Mm-hmm. But the premature ejaculation that I was talking about.
It's very annoying.
It is annoying.
It's very annoying.
It's annoying.
Yeah, well, I think a lot of men take it for
talking about
you. Premature, when the guy comes.
I don't want to know.
She doesn't know.
You say
explain what that is. To
before
her.
You complete your celebration, then he's already there.
He's already come.
He's reached his climax. That's what orgasm
is. And it's annoying to the woman.
It's annoying because the woman.
Suppose I didn't climax and he's
because just like you mentioned earlier.
Do you get orgasm every time you have sex?
She's enjoying it. I have not had for a long time. For a very, very long time.
Okay.
It's serious.
Yeah.
It's an obligation that I have made with
God
or Jehovah, yeah. That I will have to do it. I have had sex before. Mm-hmm. I have celebrated it. I have celebrated physically before. I have celebrated emotionally before. Now I want to celebrate
mental.
It. No, spiritually.
Okay.
The best way to have sex is when you do it both physically, spiritually,
okay,
and emotionally. It becomes, that's the unity, the three common in one. That's
okay.
what I'm waiting for
but
now. All those things
were
not important.
Can I be personal as y'all posed the question,
mm-hmm.
with all the celebration
and
spiritually
mm-hmm.
and the whole thing, do you have a blowing out of the candles to celebrate, you know, like an
you
orgasm?
You get orgasm.
Oh, finally.
Oh,
okay, that's right. What I mean, the climax.
This time around that I've decided to wait until I can get these three things together.
Oh.
I am looking for this spiritual partner who can meet me at that celestial height.
Very good.
Oh, very
so
poetic.
That time, yeah.
Very nice.
Yeah, no, spiritual. Somebody who is equally yoked with God a little bit, have the God-fearing thing, because I don't want to go stand at the gates again and start looking for Mr. Right. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
I'm preparing myself to meet the person.
No, I understand what you're saying. Yeah.
America, I'm preparing to meet the
so
person.
So you evaded my question.
Do
you get orgasm?
Before, a long time ago when I used to celebrate.
Have you ever had an orgasm?
No.
Oh, beautiful, holy, holy, holy.
Okay, righty now.
Finally, you answered my question.
I want to hear what she says.
Okay.
And how does she do it?
I have had orgasm, and it's a beautiful experience.
Mm-hmm.
It takes all my stress away. I feel comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I'm in heaven.
Mm.
So yes, I have had orgasm.
How long did the heaven state last?
30 seconds.
Is that some angel?
Oh, I saw more
I
than
felt
angel.
Like I was an angel.
Yes, when I did engage in sex many moons ago, yes, I've experienced very nice.
What about you?
Can I just say I was a virgin? No, she's not.
Do I not look like a virgin?
I look like a virgin.
I look like a like a virgin?
But you want to be a virgin?
It doesn't matter.
What's
it
a virgin? Matter. What's virgin a virgin? She hasn't had any in a week.
There you go. There you go. There you go.
No, but is there a difference? Okay, can I ask you all a question? Can I ask you all a question? What's your experience when you were, say, back in your teenage years or early 20s and when, you know, when we are not over 30, mind you.
No.
We're just growing up. We're talking about when we were like little frisky. What's the difference between then and now? The relationship in terms of having,
you're
celebrating.
That's
because you're more, because you have matured as a person. I know myself, you know, as a, I'm not.
Did you enjoy the orgasm then than now? Is what I want to know. Other words.
I will when I
up to now?
No, I'm saying I'm not in a relationship. Let's put it that way. So I'm not. But I will.
Well, look at who is saying until now. Did you just tell us that you haven't had
more two? Yes, yes.
I'm
almost 2 years.
Now. I know more about myself.
You think I improvise? Is that what you
want
to
know? Wait, let me finish. Let me finish telling you about how I would enjoy it. Why? Because I'm a different person now. I know myself better. Mm-hmm. I know what I don't like, what I do like. I'm not out there trying to prove something the way I was when I was my 20s.
I want to know when you're in your 20s. How did you prove yourself?
Well, that question is a different. I don't think that's appropriate right now because it goes and takes into too many other aspects that would take over too much time.
She covered it really well.
I not do that well.
You did very well. Okay. How about that for segue?
Let's look at something else. I've been watching a lot of those court type television shows, like People's Court and whatnot. And it seems like women, when we get into relationships, we sign our lives away. I mean, people suing people for taking credit cards, you know, things like that. They give their money to their... I mean, what is this?
I think women are more trustful individuals, and I don't think it's a matter of being stupid or being in love or whatever. I think you meet a person, you trust them, and you think that you're going to have a relationship or a life together. And when it comes to that, you go out of your way to do extra for the person. And you know, they take advantage, and I can relate to that. You know, I mean, I'm not going to go into details.
Okay.
So mine wasn't a matter of being stupid; it was just a matter of love and wanting a better life for the person, and going the extra mile.
But shouldn't we be on our guard when we get into relationships? Money is one of those things that really can put, you know, something between couples, no matter how much.
It's not even just couple. I think people in general, how you relate to a person. Generally, I'm a kind, given person.
You are?
Yes. And if somebody needs, yes. Don't worry, I'll be very kind.
You better get a check-in.
Yeah, you wait.
If a person is in dire need, I'm able to help. I will help the person. So whether the person is a man or a female, and I'm taking advantage of, that's the person's loss. Because once you show me your true colors, you'll never get that help from me again.
Will you? Because I had a friend who was married to this guy. They separated, or she ran away from the husband because of abuse. He went and got a divorce in her absence, because I think you can do it after 2 years or something, and got married to another woman. She finished her master's, was working, making money, met him again. He didn't divorce the other woman, but he was keeping both of them. But keeping my friend, spending her money, he will come, give a little celebration, and she's put him on her credit card. And he used the credit card to buy flowers for other women, fly women outside the country. And by the time the relationship was over, in a period of about 10 years, she was in debt for about 30 years. She's still $30,000.
She's still
paying.
That's horrible.
And I think that is just a bit too much.
That was a rich woman.
Well, she was making
good money.
She was in love. So when you're in love, you open your pocket.
We're not saying that.
Sometimes you do. When you really care about, as Gifty said, you're normally a caring, giving person. You find yourself in a situation like that. You just want to help out, and people will be abusive. and they will take advantage of you.
But look at you all putting, giving women so much sympathy. What about the men? We've been doing it for ages, you know, making them suffer.
No, that's
eating their money and running away. Yes. No. Women have done it before. It's strange now that it's women's turn, you know, to do it to them. So
I disagree with you.
Mentally. I think most of the time women really stick around with men.
They do.
The other way around, women help men and men tend to run away.
Because we have more sentiments, or we are sentimental in nature, you know, we feel, we still think of our men as our boyfriend, as our babies, you know.
That's why. And we tend to be taken advantage of more.
Because like I would take advantage of our parents sometimes. The men do get away with a lot of stuff.
Yeah, of course.
If any relationship is to last, the women work more than the men. You understand? Yeah. It's always the women working. Right. Why, God, did you create it that way? Let's move on to the other topic before we run out of time.
Would you lie about your age to get a job if it means it's a better job?
No, I would not.
Would you?
I look 9 years old?
What are you going to do at 9, though?
There is this lady right here. I hope the camera picks it up. She's right here. She's 32 years old.
Mm-hmm. She doesn't look.
And she lied about it. She changed her age. She invented herself as a 18-year-old, changed her name, and became a writer for the show Felicity on UPN.
Yeah, I watch it.
No, it's not UPN, WB. And then she was given a contract by Disney, and then they found out that she wasn't 18, she was 32. Mm-hmm. I mean, did she go too far, though?
Yes, I think she went too far. So now, what are they going to do with her? Is she going to lose her job? Or
they weren't sure, they were looking at it, but I'm sure they're going to go with the fact that she lied and stuff.
That's a major lie.
She was talented. She was able to do her work.
Because now she can't be trusted.
That's a major lie.
Well, sometimes people, you know,
would you say desperate?
Times take desperate means. Mm-hmm. Okay,
right.
I mean,
is that not a clean cut way of earning a living?
No.
I mean, that's something that could easily be found out. I mean, we all
look at that face and tell me.
It has nothing to do with that. I mean, she's not trustworthy. How can you work with a person like that?
Really, if you tell a lie, it's perjury, right? And then they can fire you for that.
Perjury is when you lie to the court, you know, in the legal system.
But sometimes you sign legal papers when you work, you know, right?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's deal with one other issue. Do you believe in spanking?
Yes, absolutely. I don't even have to think about that. I'm an old-fashioned mother, and I believe I'm not talking about abusing your child, but a good old-fashioned spanking where the child knows that you're serious and they, you know, yes, I'm definitely for it. I'm not talking about putting bruises on your child, you know, things like that.
I agree with her. I mean, I'm a mother of two, and I believe that spanking, if you need to, you need to do it. I don't believe in abuse, but you have to. I don't believe in holding a rod and spoiling the child. You have to do what you have to do, and children do need discipline.
That's right.
I don't care, because if you don't do it, the system would take care of your child.
How do you manage to discipline your child in this culture?
In my house is Africa. Outside is America. Mm-hmm. The way I was raised is the way I'm raising my child.
That's the way.
Although I was initially very angry, my father being very strict, I think had he not been, I would not have turned out the way that I am today.
Mm-hmm. But do you think that's the best way for
it's not the best
you find
way.
Yourself in a different society now?
I try to be more liberal, but at the same time, in terms of discipline, I do discipline my child if I have to.
You think by the time they're old enough, they can, you know, bring you out and say, my mother abused me?
No, I think,
that's a difference between abuse and spanking. I don't hit her to put bruises on her.
Mm-hmm.
But if she does something wrong, I'm not going to smile in her face and say, it's okay, Alexis, or it's okay, Nicole. I would not do that. Mm-hmm. I would let her know what's right and what's wrong.
Because sometimes you do leave emotional spanking in the minds of the kids.
No, and they never forget
that.
If that's the case, I will end up in a mental institution. Mm-hmm. I could say my father abused me then. Okay?
Right.
But that's a different society, right? We have run out of time,
ladies. Thank you very much for
thank you.
This is Lajimi for talking to you. Bye bye.
Ta-ta, New York.